Hello and welcome to another video where we look at the Mac. In this video, we're going to tackle an essential that every Mac user should master. Cut, copy, and paste. With cut, copy, and paste, not only will you increase your productivity, but also transform the way you use your Mac. I personally use cut, copy, and paste countless times a day. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see, stick around till the end. I'll share a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in making these videos. All right, let's get started with cut, copy, and paste on the Mac. The first thing we're going to take a look at is terminology. Now, the way that cut, copy, and paste works is through an internal clipboard. So when we go and cut something or copy something, what it does is it puts it into an internal clipboard on the Mac, and we can actually view that clipboard. It can only hold one thing at a time, and I'll talk a little bit more about that when we demonstrate cut, copy, and paste. So we have the clipboard. This is what makes it all work. The first thing that we can do is we can cut. When we cut, let's say we're cutting some text, a word or a paragraph out of a document. When we cut that, what it does is it removes it from the original document. It could be Pages, Microsoft Word, whatever we're using. And then it puts it into this clipboard. And then from there, we're able to paste it somewhere else. So cut removes it. Now, if you don't want to remove it, what we can do is we can copy it. Copy doesn't actually remove the selected item, but what it does do is it stores a copy of it in that clipboard again. And then, once it's in the clipboard, what we can do is we can paste it. This will insert that, whatever we copied or cut from that clipboard into a new location, such as another document or anything like that. There's one other term that I want to cover, and that is paste and match style. When we go and cut or copy something, not only does it copy the text, but it also copies the format of that text. So if it's bold, if it's italic, it'll copy that and put that into that clipboard. And then when we paste it, it'll also paste the formatting. Well, if you don't want to do that, you can paste and match style. So what this will do is it'll paste whatever we have in that clipboard, and it's going to match the style of where we're pasting it. And I'll talk a little bit more about that in a little bit. But those are the basic terms or how it all works. We cut something, we copy something, it goes into the clipboard. And then from there, what we can do is we can paste what's ever in the clipboard into another document. If we don't want to use that same style that we cut or copied, we can also paste and match the style. So that's the basics of cut, copy, and paste. So now that we know how it all works or what the terminology is, let's go and take a look at how this all works. We're first going to look at how we use cut, copy, and paste. And then from there, what we'll do is we'll take a look at how we paste and match the style. So let's go over to my Mac. So I'm looking at my Mac here, and let's first take a look at copy. I'm going to go with copy, and then we'll take a look at cut. With copy, what it's going to do, if I select any text, so I'm in my Notes app here, and if I select any text, let's just go with Claude here. You can see that it is bold. I select it, and then we have a few different ways to copy it. All we have to do is to edit in the menu bar when it is selected, and then you're going to see copy. So that's one way of doing it. Another way is through the contextual menu. This is when you hold down the control key and click on it. So I just go over here to Claude, I double click on it to select it, hold down the control key and click, I have my contextual menu, and then you're going to see copy. And then the third way, which is the way that I highly recommend, is using key commands. Command C, because this works for all applications. Command C is the global shortcut for using copy. So if you're in Pages, Numbers, NextEdit, or even the Finder, Command C is going to copy what you have selected. So that's why it's great to just learn these key commands. It's super simple. So I just go over here to Claude. I use Command C. And now it just copied that. If you look, being that I copied it, it is still in my document here. What it did is it copied that and placed it into the clipboard. So that's copy. Basically, cut works the same way. I can go up to edit here, and you're going to see we have cut. I can also use a contextual menu, double click, and I also have cut. And then, of course, we can use a key command. Again, what I highly recommend. How do we cut? That is Command X. So it's next to the C there on your keyboard. So when I use Command X here, watch what happens. I select it, Command X, we can see that it disappeared. So it cut it. It didn't delete it, well, actually deleted it out of the document, but it placed it into the clipboard. So how do we view this clipboard? Well, basically all we have to do is go back over to the Finder. So I'm just going to click on the desktop here. And when we're in the Finder, under Edit, we have the option to show the clipboard. We can only do this when we're in the Finder. We can only view the clipboard when we're in the Finder. So let's go ahead and select it. And we can see we have my clipboard. And in the clipboard, we have Claude. Now this clipboard here can only contain one thing. It doesn't have any type of history. So if I go and copy something else, it's going to replace this Claude. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's go over here to titles. I'm going to copy it this time. And now when we go back over to my Finder, I'm just going to click here. My clipboard is going to show. You're going to see that it copied titles. And it copied the formatting. Remember, it was bold last time. Now it is regular text. All right, so that's cut and copy. Now let's take a look at paste. When we paste, what it's going to do is take whatever is in this clipboard, and it can be text, it can be an image. And it's going to place it wherever you want to paste it. So I'm in Text Edit here. I can go to another app. So I copied it out of Notes, and I'm going to paste it into Text Edit. I could paste it into Pages. I could paste it into Excel. I could paste it into Microsoft Word. All I have to do is just click where I want it. And then again, we have three options. I can go up to Edit, and then you're going to see Paste. I can also Control Click, and then you're going to Paste. And then my favorite way is Command V, as in Victor. So now I just hit Command V, and we can see it pasted it with the proper formatting. It's a bullet. So if we go and copy, actually let's go ahead and undo this. If we go and copy this Claude, so I just copied it, Command C, and then I go over here to my Text Edit and I paste. You're going to see that it kept it bold because it's copying that formatting as well. So that's the basics of cut, copy, and paste. You really don't even have to have that clipboard open. I really don't. I just wanted to show you how this all worked. And I would highly recommend that you use the key commands. Command C to copy, Command X to cut, Command V to paste. And that's basically all you have to do. This works across multiple applications. It can even work with images, and it can work with files. So let's go over to website. I have this picture of Taylor Swift. I'd like to copy this and paste it into a document. Well, all I have to do is just click on it to get to the image. And then if I control click on it, what I'm able to do is copy this image. When I copy it, it's going to place it into the clipboard. So let's go ahead and select it. And if we this window here, close a few of these windows here. And now we go over to my Finder. You're going to see that it copied that image, or my clipboard, I'm sorry. You're going to see that it copied that image. So now what I'm able to do is take this and paste it into this document here. So I go Command V, and we can see that it pasted that image in there. We can do the same thing with files. I can't post a file in here, but we can copy and paste files. I'm just going to hide these. We'll hide the notes. And open up a new Finder window. We'll go over here to Downloads. So I want to copy this cookbook. All I have to do is Command C. I've now copied it. And then if I wanted to put it into a different folder, let's go to my Documents here. I hit Command V. And now what it did is it pasted that into that folder. So I copied it, still in the original folder, but now I also pasted it into this folder. So I basically just duplicated it. So we can do this with files. We can do this with images. There are limitations to cut. We can't always cut everything. We can, for the most part, copy everything, but we can't cut. As an example, if we go back over to my file here, I have it selected. If we go up under Edit, you're going to see that I can copy it, but I can't cut it. The cut is grayed out. If I were to control click on to get to the contextual menu, again, I can copy it, but I have no way of cutting it. If I go back to that website, I can copy that image, but I can't cut it. We can't cut an image out of a web page. So there are limitations to cut. For the most part, we can copy everything, but we can't always cut everything. So those are the basics for cut, copy, and paste. Now let's take a look at how we can paste and match style. This is a little bit different here. As I mentioned, when I paste, what it's going to do is it's going to copy the formatting and then paste whatever is in another document. Well, maybe I don't want to have that formatting in there. Let's go ahead and open up my notes again. And then we're going to go over to Text Edit. We're going to delete Taylor Swift there. And I have Claude here. It is bold and it is bulleted. Let's go ahead and copy it. And now what I'm going to do is paste it over in this document here. But remember, it's going to paste it with all of the formatting. I don't want to have it with all that formatting. I'd rather have it match the formatting of this document. Maybe I have a different font in this document. So I want it to match that style. Well, that's what paste and match style does. Well, basically to do that, what we have to do is go up to edit here, and then you're going to see the option paste and match style. I can also use a key command, and that is command option shift V. If you don't use this that often, it's probably just as simple to go up to the menu bar. Most of the time, unless you're in Microsoft Word or something like that, you'll just use paste. When I select this, watch what happens. It did it bold, it did not indent it. So it copied the text, but it didn't apply the formatting. Actually, what it did is it applied the formatting of whatever is in this document. So it's going to paste it and then match this particular document. So that's what paste and match style does. So that is how we cut, copy, and paste on the Mac. I would highly recommend that you learn the key commands, command C to copy, command X to cut, and command V to paste. This does work, as I mentioned in the introduction, across all of the different applications. You could be in Things, you could be in Reminders, you could be in Microsoft Word, Microsoft Excel, you could be in Safari, you could be in Google Chrome. Command C is still going to copy whatever you have selected. Command X is going to cut it if it can cut it. And then Command V will paste it wherever you have your cursor. Again, works across all the different applications. So that is how we work with cut, copy, and paste on the Mac. Are you still here? Did you like the video? Well, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe and even share it with friends and family. Here's a little bit about me. I think I've been creating these easy-to-follow videos like this for over a decade. You can find these videos on YouTube and on my site, danstutorials.com. With YouTube, 400 videos, and that is growing. But on my site, I have over 2,100 videos. I've been doing this a lot longer on my site than I have with YouTube. I also host webinars and classes on my site, and I have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius. You can help support my efforts by becoming a member of my site. Members get all the videos ad-free. You get access to my webinars and online classes. And you get help from my AI assistant. On top of that, you are helping support a small business. Check out Dan's tutorials for more information. And thanks for watching.